This video was brought to you by Wix. It has been such a long time since I've stood here to film a video. I always feel like I've forgotten how to do this. But anyway, several thousand of you have joined this channel since I last posted, and it casually turns out that today is the second anniversary of this channel. So, hi everyone, my name is Inés, I make videos about science, and I'm so excited to say that I am back. As I hoped I would be. Anyone with a PhD, or honestly anyone who's lived life for long enough, knows that not everything quite goes to plan. Originally, I was planning on having handed in my thesis a couple of weeks ago. I would then have edited the humongous backlog of videos that I have sitting on my hard drive, and I thought that by now I would be posting weekly videos on your curiosity. However, one of my chapters came back with corrections, my hand-in deadline was then extended. On top of the surprise extra thesis writing that awaits me, I'm also going to various conferences over the next couple of months, which, don't get me wrong, I am so excited for, and there will be videos there, but they are competing for my time as well. And at some point over the next 4 months, I also have to make a few very big life decisions, such as deciding what country I'm going to live in, move house, so you know, lots of different things. So I am back on this channel, but in the short term, I do anticipate that I will be posting one or two times a month rather than every week, but I will be gradually transitioning up to weekly in October. As well as being back, I have also finally launched a Patreon. Last year, there were lots of people asking if there was any way of supporting this channel, which means a lot to me, and there were quite a few very generous donations on PayPal, which I'm incredibly grateful for. Thank you so much, you know who you are. But I was hesitant to open Patreon because I knew I was going to be taking the hiatus that I've just come back from, and I thought it would be incredibly deceitful to launch Patreon and then disappear for a few months. But now I am back, so if you enjoy my content and you want to support it, it is now possible to do so. I'm very open to expanding the rewards that are currently available. Right now, Patreons have access to videos before everyone else, credits in the description and in the video itself, access to additional content such as behind the scenes, digital downloads of photos and time lapses I've taken, extended interviews with guests, etc, etc. And for those of you who choose to support the channel before this coming October, which is when I think I'll be posting regularly again, as an extra thank you for believing in me and supporting my content early, until the end of the year, you will also get the rewards from the tier above the one you pledge and an invitation to an exclusive live stream. So if you're interested, you can visit the link to find out more. And now for the main part of the video. I know it's taken a while to get here, and it's also 5 months late, but I really loved making the year in review video last year, and I really wanted to make one for 2017 because a lot of things happened last year for which I am so incredibly grateful, and a lot of it, again, is thanks to all of you watching and supporting my content. I'm really not trying to show off with this video, I really just want to show what your support can enable me to do, how grateful I am for it, and to be able to continue giving back. So here goes, 2017. I kicked it off by visiting Geneva and going to CERN.
95 meters below ground. So if you want to start with a stopwatch with me, you can work out how fast we're going. Very quickly, this is the CMS detector. You will see it in all its glory. This is a schematic diagram which was produced maybe in 2004. As I said, the CMS experiment is a cylindrical onion.
I coordinated a Discover Your Own educational YouTuber for Valentine's Day. I travelled to a distant exoplanet by testing the limits of my visual effects software.
Hey, we made it! We're on Travis F.
I went to Madrid to TubeCon Spain to talk about science, creating science content and animal vision. I launched a Spanish science channel called Inestable, which I promise is coming back as soon as I have time. I went to VidCon Europe. Honestly, I tried a lot of things last year, both on and off of YouTube. Some were definitely a lot more successful than others, but they all definitely taught me something new. I did a lot of speaking. Locally, I took part in various science cabarets, PubHD, Pint of Science. I even went beyond my usual comfort zone and I tried my hand at comedy for the first time at the Science Museum Lates.
And suddenly, everything was wet. I had the diarrhea. That a pigeon had just scored 500 points on my head.
And I also compared for Green Man Festival's Einstein's Garden for families and young children who are interested in science. I entered my video on pregnancy tests to the Biochemistry Society's Science Communication Competition, and I won a prize. I put myself forward for a TV casting for a science-themed game show. I was actually flown out to Cape Town, South Africa, won $1,000, made new friends and saw some Cape Townian wildlife. I was invited to lead Merck's Curiosity campaign in Berlin, which was a ton of fun. I was a panellist for Science on YouTube at Somewhere in the City. I also applied for the BBC's call for women experts in various subjects, including STEM. Now, originally, this was one of these things that I thought I hadn't got, I never heard back. But then a few months later, received an email saying that I'd been selected out of over 2,000 applications. So in September, I was media trained by the BBC for talking about science on TV and radio. Then later that day, I would fly to Bilbao to speak at Naugas to a live audience of 2,000 about insect flight, which was absolutely thrilling.
That their flight is impossible. O sea, sé que los insectos no pueden volar. Pues en tu cara, Antoine Magnot. Obviamente, las abejas, los insectos pueden volar.
And I then attended CERN's first edition, which was an event all about digital science communication in Spanish, from gaming to YouTubers to illustrators to podcasters. I was also invited to feature on Orbita Laica's fourth season premiere, which is Spain's only proper science programme, and I met Ruth Lorenzo there, who represented Spain in Eurovision. She has an absolutely incredible voice, and I found out she also loves flies and science. At the end of 2016, I also remember I said I would be working on my OCD. I know it's not quite related to YouTube and science, but it's very important to me. And I'm so proud to say that after a good 4 years of hard work, I have now been well over a year off medication, I completed all of my psychological therapy, and in spite of the ever-present stress that is having a thesis hanging over your shoulder, I am mostly symptom-free. I also interviewed candidates for Oxford admissions, I applied for several grants, and I landed the one I wanted the most, which was the Vlogbrothers grant. And I'm so proud of that as well. I'm actually using it to fund a couple of upcoming Draw Curiosity series, and I'm using it for some of the equipment that I really, really need to make videos. And after all of that, there was radio silence. I know there's been a lack of videos this year, and you might have been wondering, how on earth was I doing a PhD at the same time? And honestly, that's why you've not really seen much of me since last summer. Now, as for the present, what's coming for Draw Curiosity this year? Now, firstly, I have to finish the thesis, and I also have still a lot of content to catch up on. I actually have around 10 unedited videos, 7 are sciencey vlogs where I've visited interesting places that I wanted to share with you. Then I have 5 or 6 science videos as well, waiting to be posted. I'm also going to a few conferences and I will be making a few videos there as well. I'm going to be going to VidCon Anaheim, the one in California. So if there's anyone you would like to see me collaborate with, feel free to let me know in the comments below and we might just be able to organise something. I'm also preparing a few scripts on topics I'm very excited about relating to vision, evolution, flight and more. So I guess overall I should just hurry up with my editing. And finally, I asked you all on Twitter, if you were a tech-savvy fly, what kind of website would you create? And it seemed that you all wanted to see a travel agent. And why did I ask you this? Well, I wanted to challenge today's sponsor, Wix, to see if I could build any type of website on the fly. Wix is a platform which enables you to build just about any kind of website under the sun, a blog, a portfolio, an e-commerce website, a restaurant, you name it, and they have a template for it. Not only that, but it is entirely customizable. In fact, I was able to set up my Fly's bookable travel lodge in my back garden with a holly leaf, a table, and a tulip in only 10 minutes. So if you're interested in creating your own website or one for your pet fly, whatever the type, go to wix.com/go/draw_curiosity and build your own website today. And as always, thank you so much for watching me. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.